What did you like better, Jedi or The Empire Strikes Back?
Empire.
Blasphemy.
All Jedi had was a bunch of Muppets.
Boring conversation anyway.
Hey, Star Wars fans, and welcome to Boring Conversation Anyway. This is episode 118, and I am your host, Chris. How's everybody doing today? And as always, I am joined by my good friend, Thor. Thor, what's going on, buddy?
Not much.
No, what are you up to?
Not much. Not much. Nothing. I don't know.
I thought you froze, and I thought it was just going to say not much over and over again, because you had the same head position. He's not with me today. He's over the Skype airwaves.
Yeah. I'm on house arrest.
Yeah. Been a pretty busy week. We have a lot going on, so we're just trying to get together. So nothing much, huh? Reading any books, or what's going on with that?
Nothing Star Wars.
No.
Nothing. Still working my way through that second Lord of the Rings book.
Yeah.
But yeah, nothing Star Wars yet. Oh, that's on my list. Do the Scoundrels book. And
okay.
I've been meaning to read that second Han Solo trilogy book for a while now.
A.C. Crispin?
Yeah.
Nice. Okay. So very cool.
Get to that at some point.
Yeah, man. I just finished reading The Martian, which I thought was a great book. Unbelievable book. And then I just bought the movie the other day and got to watch it, and it's just so cool. I've only seen it like once before. It's like, that movie's like 6 years old already.
Yeah.
But really cool. Yeah. So yeah, not much Star Wars going on. Though I am getting ever closer to supposedly when I'll be getting this Razor Crest.
Yeah. It's been a while.
Yeah. Sometime in the fall, they said. So I guess starting the 21st of September, it's technically the fall. So we got to start figuring it out. Mm-hmm. But they did officially announce that this fall, they'll be putting the Rancor up for the Black Series HasLab project. So now it's definitely announced now. So we'll see how that is.
Yeah.
But other than that, what we're going to do today is a news show. And we collected all the news since the last time we did a news show, which a lot of this stuff you guys are going to know, but we'll give our takes on it and hopefully see how it goes. But I wanted to bring up the first thing is, you know, remember last year, I think it was last year, they did the Lego Star Wars holiday special?
Yeah.
Right. They're doing another one for Halloween this time. And it's going to come out on October 1st on the Disney Plus. It's Lego Star Wars Terrifying Tales. And this one follows Poe and BB-8 as they go to Mustafar to confront Grabella the Hutt, who has bought...
Let me stop you right here. I don't care, and let's move on to the next thing.
Well, I'm going to put this out there. If you care less about these things, it's going to be a quick show. I'll just say that. All right. Do you know who Indira Verma is? Indira Verma?
Sounds familiar. Is that a...
I don't want
to take a guess in case I'm wildly wrong.
She was like on Rome, and she became really famous in Game of Thrones. Which
was a real person?
Yes, she's a real
sounds
person.
Like sounds like a Star Wars name.
It does.
Yeah.
She's talking about Obi-Wan Kenobi and about how amazing it's been to be on set, and that between Deborah Chow and Ewan McGregor, they're treating it like an independent movie, whereas everybody has a say, that no one's afraid to say something that they think they could use. They might not use it, but they go back and forth. And she says you don't see that a lot on Hollywood anymore. She also said, though, that Ewan makes fun of her all the time because she knows absolutely nothing about Star Wars. She said when she was 6 years old, she used to be Princess Leia in the playground, but she never watched the movies until much later in life. In fact, she could not tell you the order the movies go in.
That's interesting.
I don't think every single person that does a Star Wars show or a movie has to know Star Wars.
No, not at all.
Right? So it's okay. I just think that it's good ribbing that when the props people hand her something and they call it by the name, she has no idea what they're saying, and Ewan has to go over there and explain what it is. So I just think that's amazing how on top of the stuff he is, you know what I mean? Because what's that?
I'm not an actor, but I felt like if I was cast in, like, let's say I was cast in Game of Thrones, right? I've never seen a single episode of Game of Thrones.
Yeah.
I would probably give it a watch just to, like, sort of get an idea for You know, especially because it's like, it's not set in the real world. It's its own world with its own, you know, I would probably give it a watch, but, you know, I've got a lot of free time, so I'm sure she's going to be wonderful.
Are you looking forward to Obi-Wan?
I don't look forward to anything. I just don't care about anything anymore. Welcome to my therapy session here on the podcast. I am not looking forward to anything.
Okay.
Even a little bit. Maybe I'm looking forward to the Batman movie.
Oh, really?
Maybe I'm looking forward to Saints of Newark.
Okay. So you're not looking forward to anything Star Wars?
No.
And is that because you're afraid something bad's going to happen?
Or? Yeah, I've been burned too many times. So unless Jon Favreau is doing it, I'm cautiously optimistic, but I wouldn't say I'm looking forward to it.
See, I'll go the other way. I have not been burned by Favreau and any TV shows. Now, I know there's only been one TV show, and that was heavily involved Favreau and Filoni. But I think the tree, you know, much like in the NFL when we talk about the coaching tree, the branches spread out, I think these guys are going to be on that same wavelength. So we'll see what happens. I think I'm looking forward the most to Cassian. Because, you know, I like that time period, and I really like to see how they're going to handle it, and it'll just be cool, you know, to see the Empire at the full force at that time.
Yeah. Yeah, that's what we said about the Han Solo movie too. But
I still enjoy the Han Solo movie.
No.
Connor and I just watched
the Han Solo movie. I'm just saying that's exactly what we said about like seeing the Empire and that sort of era.
You know, when you watch that flick, it's got more potential. It should have been more. There's potential in that flick, is what I'm saying, you know?
Yes.
Yeah. So you know what? Stay with the Han Solo for a minute before we go down the rest of this list. I have not been reading this, but I've been hearing about it. You know, the War of the Bounty Hunters thing is this new big series that's been going on in the comic book world over at Marvel. And it's all about the race to get get Han Solo to Jabba the Hutt, right? So now this is going to be the canon story of what happened in between.
Wow, that sounds a lot like the Shadows of the Empire comic book.
Yeah, we talked about that, right? Yes. Kira. Kira goes up against Vader. One-on-one.
And lives?
I think she does, but I don't know.
Yeah, because they're going to kill Kira off in a comic book.
You're right. So I think she lives. So I don't know how I feel. Now, again, I don't want to give an opinion because I didn't read it yet.
Yeah, I don't think it's anything worse than a podcast where two guys talk about and judge something that neither one of us.
Oh, you're hitting them out of the park today, brother. That's for sure. I just wanted you to be aware of that. But it will be hitting the app soon, so we could slowly start reading those, which is cool. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, because I've been doing the Star Wars run from 2015. I finished Vader, and now I'm concentrating on Star Wars and get that done. Because I really want to redo all that. Not Poe, because I remember Poe. So I really enjoyed Poe. So I don't have to redo that because I do remember a lot of the stories in Poe. But I wanted to get the Vader and the Star Wars stuff done so that when they do the next one, which is – and I don't know how I'm going to feel about the next one because, you know, I love Han. And there's a lot of these books that some of the stories are okay, but then the stuff that's going on with Han is funny or exciting. So you're like, all right, I can handle it. That's just one less character they got to work off of each other, you know? So I wonder how that's going to be. But I guess you bring in Lando now, right? So maybe you just replace him with Lando.
I don't know.
All right. Let's move on to the next bit of news. You know, the Ahsoka series got some news from the Hollywood Reporter that they are going to hire a lead actress to play Sabine Wren. We've heard about Thrawn. We've heard rumors about Ezra. Now we're not even getting a rumor. We're getting an actual fact that they're getting Sabine Wren. So is the Ahsoka show going to be the live action Rebel show?
I don't know. I've been tired of Ahsoka since like 1999. So it's fine. It's fine. I'm interested. I'll watch it.
Listen, you come here for the great analysis. That's why people sign up.
Like, people come here to see what mood Thor is in. Are going to be excited about something, or is he just going to casually
Can I ask a question, man? Are you afraid of me? Because when you're in the house with me, you're a totally different dude than when you're alone. So, like, are you trying to make sure you don't, like, you're on top of everything when you're here? Is that what it is?
I think your dogs cheer me up. Maybe I'm just, being in, like, you know, in your basement around all the cool Star Wars stuff, maybe it affects me in some sort of way.
It gets you into it.
I mean, no, listen, like, I'm cool with I really do have, like, a lot of, I think it's going to be good. And I also, you know, am I sick of Ahsoka? No, I'm not. I just want to see her die so bad. And nothing against her. It's just, what is this? Like, let's get rid of, I don't know. There's probably a lot of people that do not agree with me. They're probably like, we want to see Luke Skywalker die. So how about that?
I'll put it, okay. I could see her getting oversaturated. If that makes sense, okay? In your mind, she might be oversaturated already. But,
I don't know.
She was well used in The Mandalorian. She did not take over the show.
I liked it.
Yeah, she did not blind out anybody else. She just did her part. And it was
very cool to see her live action and you know what? I think... I don't know. It's cool. Maybe I'm just tired of Star Wars. Maybe I need to retire from this podcast.
All right, Sean.
Just done with it.
I hope Brian's listening. So, all right. So,
yeah.
But, I understand. You know, there's not a ton going on right now in Star Wars either, too. You know, we finished the Bad Batch, which we talked about that enough, but, you know, we thought it could have been trimmed down a bit, but you know,
let me put it this way. I miss George Lucas.
I understand that, but I really think I don't think Filoni and Favreau are that far away from George Lucas.
But they answer to people, and George doesn't, and never did.
Okay, so I understand. So you miss the setup about how he was at the top. If he wanted something done, he's going to do it. We're going to finish all the deleted scenes in post so people can see what they look like. No one's paying that kind of money. No one's doing that. But he did it. You know, that kind of stuff. I see what you're saying. And the decision making starts and stops with him.
Yeah. And then you could also, I mean, there's the counterpoint is always like, well, you know, a lot of the Star Wars, like the prequels and stuff, or maybe a little bit, you know, he certainly made decisions and things that fans at the time and still now didn't love. And also, like, there was a lot less Star Wars. You know, we got three movies after the original three, and that took almost 20 years. You know, you got the show. So I appreciate that there's, like, more Star Wars and that sort of thing. I think I'm just, I don't know, ready for something new and exciting, or something that I feel like isn't just, you know, the Obi-Wan show, the Ahsoka show, you know, it just seems like too much sort of,
okay.
A little too corporate for me.
I didn't put this in the news, but it's a heavy rumor out there that Finn is going to get his own show. Would that be Finn's show? Yeah,
Boba Fett show.
Okay, but that's what they're doing. But is Finn more interesting to you because you don't know anything about the future after Rise of Skywalker? Is that time period more interesting?
Episode 11 is more interesting to me. Or, what, 9? Which one are we on? We made 9 of these. Episode 10 is more interesting to me.
Yeah, 10.
And 11. And 12. And I'm not quite ready for it. And certainly, like, you know, I would be the first person to be like, no, you burned it pretty hard with the last trilogy. But I just want Star Wars to kind of be like Star Wars. I don't know.
Well, okay.
I think I'm missing the excitement of, like, a Star Wars movie.
Well, the last one was, what, 2019, right?
It's not long ago, I know.
No.
We just kind of got spoiled with, like, that that span of like
bang, bang, bang.
5 years of a movie every year.
Yeah, I get it. I mean, I'm excited for Boba Fett. There's a character I could care less about before The Mandalorian. Really.
I was never on that Boba Fett train.
Joe was.
I agree. I don't want Diet Boba Fett, though. Just like I don't want, you know, Diet Star Wars. Like, I don't want Diet Boba Fett, who's and his blaster to stun or something like that. I'm not saying that's going to be the case.
Right, because I don't think we got Diet Boba Fett inside the show. You know, Well, we haven't yet, so we can't say we've seen it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I'm just waiting for, like, the scene where Boba Fett's like, has to identify his ship, and he's like, oh, it's that one. It's the one with, the wings on the side. Yeah, but what's it called?
I think it's the fire spray now.
It's not, don't worry about it. Just get on my ship! But certainly it's got the right people doing it, so I'm excited.
Yeah, I mean, Filoni's writing all of Ahsoka.
I think I'm a jerk, because I've just loved ragging on people who like Boba Fett for like the last 30 years, right?
So you don't want to have to be in that camp.
So if you make Boba Fett cool, then it takes the fun out of it for me.
Well, you can still rag on Boba Fett. Like Joe's version of Boba Fett that he loved was a guy who fell into a hole.
I know.
You know what I mean? So you're okay with that. It's like you still make fun of that.
Yeah.
You know, what did he do? He followed a ship.
I think the worst thing that I think the thing we've learned here in this therapy session for me is that if Star Wars was everything I liked, I would hate it because I just want to give everyone a hard time about it.
Yeah, it's
I'm just what's it called? A troll? I'm a troll. Everybody.
Yeah, you're ornery. Yeah, yeah, troll. Yeah, yeah, I guess
I'm a troll.
Well, if you want any good news about movies, we got a little bit about Taika Waititi's done with Thor. Yeah, go ahead. Go ahead.
Sorry. Did they kill Bib Fortuna on The Mandalorian? I don't remember.
Yeah, fat Bib Fortuna. They killed him.
All right, we didn't need to specify him being fat.
I just
fat,
want to make sure, because maybe that wasn't him. Well, maybe that was his cousin.
Well, actually, you know, maybe it's an important point, because I always bring up how, you know, Star Wars loves killing fat guys, so they will now fatten one up just to kill him. So maybe when I start seeing, like, a 250-pound Ahsoka, I'm like, oh, it's coming. They're finally getting rid of her.
Oh, my God.
All right, what's next?
Just Taika is letting everybody know that he's done with Thor. What was it? Love, God, I don't know what it is. The one that's something, coming out. Love and Thunder. Yeah. So he's finished. So he is currently writing the script for Star Wars. He says we're still in the exterior space stage, but we've got the story, and I'm really excited because it feels
what
very...
What does that mean?
What's that?
Exterior space stage.
Meaning the script hasn't been hashed out, but the story has been hashed out. You know, the first part of the script, you ever... If you read a Star Wars script, which, because you haven't, the first thing it says is exterior space. Because the first thing that always happens is in space.
So they put a scene heading on, and that's as far as they've gotten. Is that what you're telling me?
So he's got the story, but they're writing the script now. But he says it feels very me. So I don't know if that's going to make you feel better or not.
I mean, it does, because I love him and I love his work. I think it's sort of like a... I mean, he probably too is like, I hate talking about projects before they come out. Just
right.
Like, wait and see. Because, yeah. Like... Saying it feels very me is just weird, because it's like, oh, you weren't getting drunk and then writing it blindly and reading it back the next day, and who wrote this?
he was in that movie I saw with Connor, The Free Guy.
Oh, was he?
He's the bad guy, and he chews up the scenery in that flick. He's so good in that movie, man. You know, I forgot just from, because he's been, you know, he directs so much, and
that's the way I always think of him.
Right. You know, I still haven't seen Jojo Rabbit. Everybody tells me too. And as soon as I get time, I will see it.
Yeah.
But he's really good in The Free Guy. I was really impressed with The Free Guy. I just thought it was going to be okay, but it was really good. Yeah. So that's cool. you just mentioned about talking about projects before it's done. Robert Rodriguez says, he's really hyped about the Book of Boba because he knows it over-delivers. So I'll give you the quote. I can't say anything about it at all right now, but it's coming out in December. Wait until you see what's coming. It's going to blow your mind. That's all I can say. I can talk it up all I want because I know it over-delivers. It way over-delivers. People are going to be so pumped when they see it.
All right.
I wish you could see Thor's face.
It's just... I don't fault him because he has to do interviews and stuff. It's just, I don't know, I always find it like a hard thing to talk about a project before you do. Like, I would see it all the time because, you know, I'm big into music and especially hard rock and heavy metal. And, you know, you'd have like somebody talking about their new album they're recording and they'll be like, oh, it's heavy. Oh, it's like our earlier stuff. It's like, and just all these things, like, none of it matters. Those are just so, those aren't specific comments at all. Like, Just whatever. We'll see. You know.
Right.
If you're not gonna talk about making it or anything remotely interesting, then yeah, I don't. Like, who's gonna come out and be like, you know, it didn't go great. I hope you guys check it out. But it just didn't really beat my expectations.
Yeah, we think it's okay. Maybe somebody might really like it, but we just think it's okay.
So yeah. You're into like my Mandalorian episode, you're probably not gonna love the series. I don't know.
We'll see, man. We'll see. I just think when you pump up something that much,
yeah,
people are gonna be like, you're like, when they hear that, I'm like, uh-huh. And then when it comes out, they're looking and be like, no, it's not like what you said. You know what I mean? Dude,
and he says, well, what does it mean to you for a Boba Fett series to over-deliver? First image that comes into my head is him blowing up a Sarlacc pit. Like, okay.
Not our Sarlacc pit. The Sarlacc pit. He goes back to the one.
No, all of them. All of them. They're gone. Or what's another one? Yeah, I kind of lost my...
I don't know. Maybe...
Nothing about him is really interesting.
Maybe he goes up against one of the other bounty hunters in this. That would be kind of really cool.
I'd like to see them fight like 8 Gomorian guards. Like hand combat. That'd be over-delivering.
Yeah, which ones, sweet. Though?
Any of them, I don't care.
No.
The most agile ones, the ones from The Mandalorian. Ones that can fight.
Those masks look awful. But all right. All right. Not the last bit of news, but some Disney Plus news is that at Disney Plus Spain, they released a schedule. And on it, on the September 29th, so a week after Visions, is Star Wars Galaxy of Sounds. It's shorts. From what we could tell, it's like what we've seen before with the fly-through of the spaceships and the biomes, which I called biodomes for I don't know how long until you had to tell me that that was a movie.
Yeah.
Star Wars is a lot about the sound. I mean, we did a whole episode about Star Wars sounds, so I'm looking forward to seeing this. That'd be cool. I don't know how, you know, it's still going to be some video to it. Obviously, it's not going to just have wavelengths on the Disney Plus, right? So we'll see what it is. I'm looking forward to that, though.
You're looking forward to that.
Yes, I am, because I look for things to fall asleep to as someone who works at night. And that's not a bad thing to fall asleep to.
Are you afraid to spend time inside your own mind? This isn't just you. I'm talking to society at large.
Falling
asleep to The Office and just spend some time in your own mind.
You ask Maeve, I spend too much time in my own mind.
And I don't believe that.
I spend too much time planning rooms and trying to figure out stuff. I saw the greatest meme of all time is a couple's laying in bed and the girl sitting up with her eyes open and she says, I know he's cheating on me. And he's laying on his side with his eyes open and says, I know if I move things around, I can get one more helmet downstairs.
Actually, yeah, that works pretty good. Well, you don't live in Spain, so you got nothing to look forward to.
Well, I just think a leak from Spain is what they're saying. But you don't know. Maybe. I don't think they would put something out there that we wouldn't get, though. That's not
just
fair.
Just for Spanish?
Yeah. I don't know.
Because I was looking at, like, there's an AEW pay-per-view last night.
Yeah.
This is really not relevant. But I was like, oh, okay, maybe I would watch it. And they're like, well, it's pay-per-view, so, you know, it costs $50. And I was like, yeah, that's not happening.
No. Wow.
I wouldn't pay $50 to watch, like, a state execution, let alone just, like, a wrestling pay-per-view.
Like, how much would you pay to watch a state execution?
Probably $40. Unless I was personally tied to the case in some way. But anyways.
This got dark so fast.
Or like Joe was flipping the switch. Before my friend here got this new gig.
So
killing inmates. But anyways, my point being is that like in Europe or somewhere, there you can get it for like $20 through some sort of other app that we don't have here. And it's just like, that's not fair.
Yeah, I'm sure we're going to get it.
I think it was $20. It could have been pounds or I don't know what they use over there, euros. But anyways, I'm sure we'll get the Spanish version of the Star Wars sounds.
Well, if it's sound effects, there's no language to it.
That'd be good.
All right. Well, one thing I want to tell you about, there's this article out there on Frank Oz. And
about how he's trashing the Muppets, because I've read it and it's wonderful.
Well, he trashes Disney. Yes. Yeah, it's so good.
He goes after the Sesame Street people, too, so it's not just a Disney thing.
Right, right.
Yeah.
I'm trying to find them. I forgot to put the magazine it came from, so I wanted to look that up. But the reason why it's Star Wars news is because he tells it that in the script, the original script of Empire, basically Yoda spoke backwards like one time. And the rest he spoke normal. Which, if you watch the movie, he speaks backwards a little bit, but it's still not a lot.
Oh, if you compare Empire to
the prequels,
Revenge of the Sith?
Yeah, yeah, right.
It's very different. And I've always kind of not enjoyed it. I kind of wish he toned it down. Like, he did like Empire, you know?
Right, right.
But yeah, no, it's been pretty well established that he asked George to go further with it when making Empire.
Exactly. And it's a cool piece of news that's out there. But if you really read the rest of that article,
Wait, what's the news?
That was the news.
He says it in the Empire of Dreams documentary that came out 20 years ago.
Well, it's...
That's okay. Not news.
There's plenty of fans that aren't 20 years old that are listening to us that haven't seen that documentary. And
it's
see that documentary.
It's on Disney+.
What does it mean they went into... Maybe kids aren't into documentaries now. I don't know.
Okay, well, if you're not into pursuing knowledge, you shouldn't be able to have knowledge.
Let me tell you something, buddy. If they're into documentaries on Disney Plus, then it's the crap that goes on there. Because have you tried to watch any of those behind the attraction ones?
No.
You want to wring your brain out of your head with the lady. She's screaming at you.
Screaming.
You know, it's just like, bah, woo, ah, yeah. And they cut things and they place things and it's like you can't get the full story. It really looks like those particular ones on that site, because I really enjoyed the other one. What was the one that you and I watched?
The Imagineering one is really...
Absolutely amazing.
It's a long commercial for Disney, but it's well done.
Well done. And then, so far, all the galleries, whether it's Marvel, whether it's been Star Wars, well done. This is just like, we are creating these documentaries for the TikTok gang. Because it's just like, boom, hey, ha, woo! And it's just like, wait, what? I just came here to learn about the Haunted Mansion, lady. Why are you screaming at me?
I know everything about the Haunted Mansion. But... Yeah. Hey, just to backtrack, though, and this doesn't really have anything to do with Star Wars, but it has to do with what we're just talking about. Do you agree? Because I didn't really grow up with the Muppets, but I do like them. I've seen the films now as an adult. Do you kind of agree with what he's saying?
Let's just talk about what the premise is, because I'm not going to hide it here. He hates Disney. Let's just put that. He believes Disney killed Jim Henson.
Because he did say that.
Yes. Yeah. I mean, he just came out and said that freaking Disney's like Rambo and just killed Jim Henson because because Jim was dealing with, at this point, listen, we're not there at the table, but if Jim didn't want to sell the Muppets, he didn't have to sell the Muppets.
Yeah, I don't know nearly enough about that story to really comment on it. But I do know that the story of the Muppets and Disney is kind of convoluted, and the Muppets have been sold and resold and all sorts of things.
And the deal didn't get done until after he was gone.
Yeah,
and, you know, and he passed away, and he says he passed away because he was so run down from dealing with the stuff at the table with Disney. And let me tell you my opinion. The two things that Disney did with the Muppets that was any good was the actual attraction. That's really cool and fun, which I don't even know if it's still there anymore, because I don't think it is.
It might be in Florida, but it's definitely gone
in California, right? So that was well done. And the first new Muppet movie with Jason Segel.
So that movie, I watched like half of it, and I thought it was pretty good. But kind of in hindsight, you know, they're kind of doing the thing they always do of like getting over this new Muppet rather than like focusing on our Muppets, because that movie's kind of on that Muppet character.
It brings that guy in because it's got to bring in Jason Segel, the two of the brothers.
Jason Segel's mom had sex with a Muppet. Was that what I was supposed to believe?
I don't know, but
because I get why Frank Oz is like not okay with that.
Well, Frank Oz's take on the whole thing is that they don't want people to speak back. That's why he can't be performing for Miss Piggy and Fozzie, because he's going to do it the way he did it all those years. And they want them to be clones and just listen and take orders and go.
Yeah, I worked for them. Trust me, I know.
So that's when he's upset. And like I can't blame a guy. And I think what the article was, the bombshell was, the article leads off with, you know, we know that you've been retired from doing the Muppets. And he stops him. He goes, I've never retired from doing the Muppets. Disney won't let me do the Muppets. And then when you hear that, you're like, you got to be kidding me, man. This is the guy who is best friends with Jim. He's the extension of Jim Henson. And he's not afraid of Disney at all. I mean, because
he's like, all the popular Muppets that aren't Jim Henson.
Yeah.
Well, you know, Fozzie Bear and Miss Piggy.
Right,
and,
right. But, so he's not afraid of Disney because, you know, he must have still had ill will for them before he did The Last Jedi and they got him back. So maybe he feels he's not doing anything more for Yoda so he can say what he wants and he doesn't care anymore. But it was nasty. And, I don't blame him because, as Maeve says, you keep hearing this stuff about Disney. Sooner or later, Disney's the one who's is evil. You know?
It just is what it is. And it kind of goes back to what I'm talking about. It's good and it's bad. Disney doesn't have a soul.
Right.
Because it answers to shareholders.
It's right? All corporate.
And that's why I said about, like, missing George. Because, like, right or wrong, George is a person. And Walt Disney was, you know, when he was still living. And Jim Henson certainly was. But also, it is what it is. But
I totally get it. It's what you need is the people in between that can isolate the creators from the pull from Disney, right? So you get that in Marvel. Fahey protects the people. He gets what he does. Now they have the track record, so they lay off more. But he's in place there. I think now what we're seeing in Star Wars and Lucasfilm is that Kathy is that person for Filoni and Favreau. What they want to do, she's going to make sure they accomplish whatever she's got to do to get it done. And she's going to use her power and push things back if she has to, which is the way it's got to be.
It's just reality, right? Like, you know, there was a time where you used to make something and then you'd hand it over and then they would figure out how to market it. And the time now is marketers are coming up with the thing and then you go and make it.
Which is where it gets really messed up. You're absolutely right.
That's why you have Ahsoka. That's why you have a Star Wars story. All those kind of things. And they can still come out good because you still hand it over to somebody who can do it well. But anyways.
I think Filoni pushed for Ahsoka. That's his baby. He created that baby. You know what I'm saying? So I don't think it was the corporate guy saying you have to do an Ahsoka show. I think he was pushing for that.
No, but it's like call it Ahsoka rather than just be like, oh, we're doing the show and she's going to be the character.
It's kind of gotten to that point now where it's we have to name these shows what they are, which is like, yeah, I would like to see something different. But it's like The Mandalorian, The Obi-Wan Show, The Boba Fett. At least it's the book of Boba Fett, so it's a little interesting. You know, Cassian, I don't know, what do you going to call it? Cassian, it's called the Endor.
I would call that stuff Rogue Zero. It takes place before Rogue One.
That's nice. I was going to call it the Cassian Case Files, but all right.
That's pretty good, too. We should be in marketing.
Yeah. All right.
What's next?
Last bit of news, man. Believe it or not, a lot of video game news. Some of it you're not going to like at all.
Oh, the new Tales from Galaxy's Edge is coming out.
Let's talk about that first. Yeah, the trailer came out. It's coming out in the fall. Did you see the trailer?
I think I might have.
Yeah. Doc Ondor, which is the Hammerhead guy that's in the toy shop, is giving you a mission. You're going to go up against the bad guys and stuff like that. It looks pretty cool.
I think it comes out on the 15th or the 10th, one of those.
Okay.
And it's $10. It's the expansion pack. I think you can get the whole thing for like $35.
You have
on the Oculus. So yeah, I've got the game itself, and it's a fun game. Some people complain about, like a little bit short, and also maybe not a lot of replayability. Even though there's like technically like, oh, you can go and collect these things and that. You know, I wanted to like be in Galaxy's Edge, which you never actually really are, but it's pretty cool. Even though it's sequel era. You know, in the first game, you're killing Guavian Death Gang all over the place, and It's pretty good. It's a pretty good game, I think, for the Oculus, especially if you're a Star Wars fan.
How many expansions are there that you have so far?
I think just one. No, I think this is just the one, and this is the last one.
Oh, okay. What was the...
Because I looked it up thinking maybe I missed one, because when I was reading the article, it was like, this is it. This is, the last of it. So I guess this is going to be it. But I think this one has, like, stormtroopers in it and stuff. Like, you didn't interact with stormtroopers or nothing in the first one, which is kind of a neat idea to have a different... thing to shoot at.
Stormtroopers. ILM X or something, I think. X-Lab?
Yeah.
They developed this game a while back, which was Han and Luke had to land the Falcon to get a part, and they were on Tatooine, because, where else are you going to go? And basically the game was just, because it was the first, like, VR game that they were testing out, was Han has to leave with Chewie to get the part, Luke is there to watch the Falcon, and Stormtroopers come, and all it is Luke fighting with the lightsaber. But it was really nifty, and I really thought by now it would have been released somewhere else, because I think it was on one thing, like one particular phone had it, and that was it. And I thought by now we would see it.
I think with VR, it's just maybe one still kind of niche, and then also there's a few VRs, because I would think an open world Star Wars VR game
would be sick.
Would be killer. If you just went and you're just boom, I'm in the cantina and there's other players and stuff and I can go and do these missions that pop up and kind of like Grand Theft Auto.
Right. Even if you made it scale. Because VR games, because of the technology they're using, sometimes you don't get a full game like you would get with Grand Theft Auto. But even if you got the ability, bro, to start on one planet and you got to check out the highlights, you got to see Jabba's palace, you got to see Mos Eisley, you can go see Mos Espa and go see the pod races.
That's what the game is missing, in my opinion, is because it's, 3D Oculus, it's very cool. I would just love sort of just to go to those places and see them in the 3D world, and you don't. You go to Star Wars places, you're in a ship, it feels very Star Wars, you're on the planet, I remember when I opened up a crate, not to spoil the game, and C-3PO was there. And I was like, oh my god, C-3PO. It's like he's my height. It's like he's really, really there. But you would just want to wouldn't it be cool to go on the Falcon? Wouldn't it be cool to go to these places? I'm just walking around. But in the game, there's a bar at the Galaxy's Edge that's kind of your home base. And when you look out the window, you're looking over the park. So you're looking over the Millennium Falcon. So it's oh, cool, there it is.
Yeah.
I wish I could go down there and really look at it.
We had this game for the VR for the PlayStation 4, and it was Creed. And in it, you could be Rocky. And Rocky's about my height, 5'8", 5'9", right around there, right? And I was going up against a guy that was 6'4", 6'5". So you really had, because you were talking about how C3 was your height, you really had to throw up.
Yeah.
Right? Well, the one thing we learned about this game is you needed to play with somebody in the room, because when Daddy was playing by himself, Daddy punched the TV. Thank God nothing happened, but I hit it hard, man.
Well, when you do the Oculus, you set a boundary.
Right. That's what I've heard.
You don't set one for the ceiling. Which is so I would have that problem, I can't play upstairs because my head touches the ceiling,
right?
So if I had anything to do, right, it's and when you're in the game, so much that you kind of lose you forget, I gotta watch out for the ceiling.
You know what we gotta do is I have to see what's going on, because COVID really screwed up everything. But do you remember when we were in LA, we did the Darth Vader one, the VR thing?
Yeah.
Okay. So that company was opening one in Manhattan, a permanent one, not a pop-up shop, right?
Yeah.
And they were opening it in the, I can't remember the name of it, but it's the new train station that they did by the Trade Center. And I don't know if you've seen it yet, but it looks amazing. It's got these white bone. It looks like a dinosaur thing on the outside of it. And I have to look it up, because you figure when COVID was at its top, people were not going to want to go put on HVAC suits and run around together. So I don't know what's going on there. But I know that Harry Potter, the store, it has two of those VR things going on. So maybe it's back. So maybe you can do it, because I like to support them, because I just thought that thing was so cool. And they have other ones besides Star Wars, like Ghostbusters and stuff like that. That would be kind of cool. We'll keep going with real quick with the video game news. We got a trailer finally for LEGO Skywalker Saga. That's going to be coming out in the fall. It looks really good. It's all the movies together, all nine movies. Should be a lot of fun. It's the most playable characters you can ever have in a Star Wars game.
I feel like I've been talking about this game for like
ever. It keeps getting pushed back, which is going to lead to the next story about video games. But why I crave this game, I could count on one hand the games that Connor and I could play together on the couch. Everything is designed for kids to play on you know, over the internet and online and stuff. So I'm just looking forward to that. The other thing is that there was a game just for the Nintendo Switch called Star Wars Hunters. And it was a free game, but it was gonna be like one of those free games, but then you got to pay as you're going along probably. But that's delayed to 2022. So I don't know what's going on with that thing.
It's funny you bring that up, because I was on the Switch. I was looking to see if any Star Wars things came out I might not have known about. And I saw the Hunters was there as like, you know, coming.
Right.
I had completely forgotten about it.
So, and the other thing is EA is saying they are committed to the sequel to Jedi Fallen Order. They just want us to be aware of that. Because right now it's a big mess between Disney and EA, because they have, at the end of a 10-year contract that's already been done, they already told them they're not re-signing them again, because what happened during that period is we got four games in the 10 years, right? We had Battlefront, Battlefront 2, Jedi Fallen Order, and Squadrons.
Right.
That's all we got from them. And Ubisoft Massive is doing that open world Star Wars game that's going to come out as soon as the contract is done.
Right.
So they didn't have to wait for the contract to be done to go farm it out. They went and farmed it out. They just can't put the game out until the contract's over. And it also led to the reforming LucasArts, because they realized they screwed up so bad. I mean, think about it. Since 2013, there's been four Star Wars games. It's insane.
It really is. It always has been. We've talked about it. I mean, I remember when I kind of got back into video games, this would have been like 2016, when I got a PlayStation 4, it blew my mind that there was one title on it at the time.
Right.
For Star Wars. Like, it was just like, what?
Yeah.
And it wasn't like, oh, but the Xbox has this or that. They were, every system had the same one. That's good news. Yeah.
Yeah. We've had more Star Wars titles that have been a re-release of old games than we've had of new games.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, I really enjoy Fallen Order. I'd be curious about a sequel. I don't think I would buy it the day of at full price. But like I eventually
my kid was deep into it. Deep, and he loves it.
It's decent. Dude, you know what blew my mind? I didn't realize this. Who's the woman in that game? That like the Jedi that kind of.
Oh yeah. I don't know the actress.
Remember her name?
Yeah.
Do you remember the character's name?
No.
That was anyways. It blew my mind. I don't know. Went on a weird Wikipedia deep dive, and I was looking up like Mad TV.
Yeah.
And she was from Mad TV.
Oh, really?
I don't remember watching Mad TV. Deborah Wilson, I think, is her name. I was like, oh my God, yeah. That's Mad TV. I used to watch Mad TV a lot.
That's like awesome.
When it used to re-air on Comedy Central.
That's awesome.
I don't know. It's just like a weird sort of like, and I'm glad she's doing a lot of like voice acting and stuff now, I guess.
You hang around all the time when Connor's here. Has Connor ever told you who his favorite character is in all of Star Wars?
I think he said Jar Jar Binks. No. I know the answer to this, but I can't figure it out
right now. Starkiller.
Oh, I didn't know that.
Yeah,
then.
It's Starkiller.
No way did I know
that's
that.
His favorite guy in the whole world.
I mean, yeah, you like played as him as a kid, a bunch, right?
For two games, right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh, I should go back and play that one.
I know. Got to play it on the PlayStation 3.
I've been thinking about setting up my 360.
Oh, okay, you had it on the 360.
Yeah.
All right.
But yeah. Games will be fun. Games are still exciting for me, I think.
Listen, at the very least now, by able to farm it out to other places, you can potentially have a game a year. I mean, you can maybe even have multiple titles per year.
I'll take six bad games if one good game got made.
Right.
Whereas, like, when it's just EA doing it, it's like, all right, well, I hope this is the one good one.
I want that open world Star Wars game that Ubisoft is doing to be like Red Dead Redemption, but instead of a horse, I get a Tauntaun. That's all I want. That's it.
I would go online and I would cut open your Tauntaun and then go inside of it.
All right, you ready to get out of here?
I guess. Yeah, there's nothing else.
That's it. Listen, just not a lot of news, but it is what it is, right? That's why we save it for once a month. So
I mean, yeah, I don't know. I was looking at StarWars.com. That's where I go for news. But it's usually mostly just telling you what you can buy.
Yeah, that's why I don't go there for news.
I mean, let's see here. I can tell I'm not ready to end this.
I can see, man, which I know you. I can't listen. I've known you for almost 10 years, and I don't know your body language. Because I thought you were trying to get out of that, like you was crawling out of your skin to get out of the room, man.
I don't know what's going on here. Star Wars Visions merchandise, everybody. You want socks and T-shirts? You can buy those. Vader seeks Luke and Dr. Aphra plots an escape in Marvel's War of the Bounty Hunters crossover.
Oh. It's
a preview.
So I guess he took care of Kira, no problem.
Star Wars Inside Intel, Mustafar. Okay, so there's like articles.
Yeah.
That's kind of fun.
First time on StarWars.com?
Star Wars Battles coming to Apple Arcade. First time on StarWars.com in like... since I graduated high school, and I wasn't just looking for things to do.
I saw that about the Lego, the new Lego arc. But it's going to Apple Arcade. So you got to pay a service just to play the one game. I'm like, nah, because they keep giving me free tryouts for the Apple Arcade for like 2 weeks, and by the second day, Connor's like, there's nothing on here to play. So
yeah, protect your school supplies with this Boba Fett book cover. Right.
Can I just say one thing though? You're not telling me one of the hottest merchandise out there is, I don't know if you've seen this before, but they do Japanese style warriors as like Boba Fett and Vader.
Yeah.
Yeah. So you have a Japanese style show coming out already. How do you not have Black Series at the very least, 3¾ coming out with that? People would buy that up in seconds.
Maybe. Maybe, I don't know.
Yeah. I got some stuff delivered, by the way. I got a new Endor Luke, which is okay. It's not
what
great.
What size?
3¾. I have the one for that. The reason why it's okay is the head sculpt is great. You can't take the helmet off, which I get because they're trying to shadow the vintage collection is shadowing, you know, what we had as kids, and you couldn't take his helmet off either. That's not the problem. The last one before this came with a really good belt that was molded with things on it that he had when he was in Endor, right? And this one comes with like an elastic hair tie, and that's it. It's such a downgrade. Like, if you want to make the ultimate figure, you got to take the belt from the other one and put, it's just like, come on. Like, and the other thing, it came with the skiff gun. Why did the Endor Luke come with the skiff gun?
He
steals the gun at Jabba's place. Gets a shot off before he falls into the Rancor pit. That's the last time he has that gun. He doesn't get it when he's on the skiffs, right?
I don't think so.
He asks for his lightsaber. He does the jumpy jump. He gets it and starts beating up people. So
maybe it's a common gun. You know?
I just
maybe the rebels sense. Were selling guns to, you know, the Hutts. Kind of like, never mind. Not important. I don't know any other governments that sell weapons.
But definitely not. I just thought it was interesting. I got new and new sand people, which look really cool. That is a nice sculpt on them. And then a Death Star droid, not black, it's silver, which is not the Death Star droid, but that's pulling hairs, whatever.
Dude, I saw, this is old news, but I saw a Lego probe droid at Target yesterday.
Yeah.
It looked pretty sweet.
Yes.
Pretty good.
Yeah.
Oh, also, this is definitely old news, but there's a Star Wars one-shot Life Day coming out in November.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah, I'm looking at it. I don't know. Could be cool. Steve Orlando, he's a good guy. Assuming it's the same one that I'm thinking of. And then it's like the other people from Kevin Scott and Justina Ireland are from what you call it.
I'm working on
what's that thing that we used to talk about?
High Republic.
High Republic. Yeah, yeah. and Jody Hauser, whose name I'm not familiar with, but I don't know. Could be cool. They've got on this cover. They've got the Wookiees like in like the red robes.
Oh, that's dope. Yeah, look at that. Let's throw an old saying out. Look, you bring up something pretty good about the High Republic. It's clear that Disney's only concentrating on this one area in Star Wars, right? And now they're re-releasing in waves. They're up to wave 3 already of the Legends books with new art covers to resell in case people haven't bought them in the past, right? So if you're one of these guys that's freaked out about the canon being wiped, enjoy those books anyway. Because until it's proven otherwise, why aren't they canon? You know what I'm saying? Until you see something that contradicts it, let it be your canon. It doesn't matter. You don't have to go nuts about it because they're clearly concentrating on the High Republic. So we're not going to see any books about Luke, any books about Han or anything like that. So go have at the old stuff. Why not? Some good stuff in there anyway, you know?
Yeah. Yeah, definitely.
All right. Let's get out
of
here.
Yeah, I'm done.
Good. Dredge it out. Guys, check us out at Twitter and Instagram and email us, please. We will use your suggestions on the show. If you can, leave a review. It helps us out. And if you want to support us in a different way, grab a t-shirt or a patch or a sticker from TeePublic.
There's all the stickers? Links.
Oh, there's stairs, all kinds of stuff.
Oh, dude, I want a sticker.
Get a laptop cover.
If you want to support us in a really different way, you can send just straight cash in an envelope.
To my house. To my house. Not Bethel. Yeah. No. All right, Thor, why don't you say goodbye?
All right, everybody, go make some noise.
That's my line, man. Well, that's my line from the Splash. That's an old one. He went way back.
It's a joke that nobody gets.
Now,
you, me, and two other people.
That's okay. All right, we'll see you next week. We got something really cool planned. Putting Thor on the spot. Make sure he does the homework. We'll see you next week. Go make some droids!